Thank you very much. So my research focuses on the effect of climate change on the functioning of marine ecosystems. And today I'm going to present one aspect of my research, focusing on the energy flow in marine ecosystems. So first, it's crucial to understand how marine ecosystems work. So marine ecosystem is very complex. We can represent the structure of marine ecosystems as a pyramid of prey and predators. At the base of this pyramid, we find the phytoplankton, which provide the energy for the entire ecosystems. Then zooplankton consumes phytoplankton. Then, in the next level, there are mixed group of species with crustacean juveniles. In the next level, there is several group of small fish like mackerels or sardines. And finally, at the top of the food chain, there are the top predators like cod, tunas, or sharks. So not all the food that we are consuming can be transformed into mass, because as in any biological system, a part of the energy from our food is lost. For example, we, as humans, eat 14 times our body weight per year, and therefore, in marine ecosystem, we need a huge quantity of phytoplankton to produce a small quantity of top predators. And in my research, I want to estimate these losses in measure, in energy, in the food web. So I want to answer the question: how much matter is moving from one level to the next? And based on statistical models and various data sources, in fact, with my colleagues, we calculated the transfer efficiency, which is in fact the proportion of biological matter flowing at each level in the food chain. And we found that the transfer efficiency is 6.5% in tropical ecosystems and 10.4% in polar ecosystems. But this means that to produce a small quantity of predator, for example 100 grams of top predator, 6 tons of phytoplankton is required in tropical ecosystems, whereas only 1 ton of phytoplankton is required in polar ecosystems. So polar ecosystems are much more efficient than tropical ecosystems. But this latitudinal difference in transfer efficiency suggests that the transfer efficiency is very sensitive to temperature. So we want to answer the question, what will be the consequences of the ocean warming on the transfer efficiency? For that, we work on two climate change scenarios. The most optimistic scenario in green, if we stop emitting greenhouse gases in the 2020s. And the most pessimistic scenario, the business as usual scenario, if CO2 emissions continue to increase until the end of this century at today's rate. And we found that the transfer efficiency is expected to decrease by 0.5% by 2100, if the worst case scenario happens. Finally, you're going to say, okay, but 0.5% is not that huge. But in fact, the consequences can be tremendous. For example, if we work on the biomass, the resulting change in the biomass when transfer efficiency changed by 0.5%, we found that the biomass is expected to decrease of 20% if the worst case scenario happens. For example, in this map, you can see the resulting change in abundance of marine species. In red, the decrease, and in blue, the increase. And finally, the consequences of these changes in abundance on fisheries can be also very important, with a decrease in fisheries catch potential, with economic impacts, but also food security issue in many countries, and especially where food protein is a key resource. Thank you.
Thank you.